The first one is average current or DC current. Average current or DC current. It is denoted by I suffix DC. The formula for this one is IDC equals to 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi. Your signal is a sinusoidal signal. Yes or no? Output looks like this. Okay. Amplitude is assume Im sin omega t d of omega t. This can be divided into two parts. 0 to pi, take Im outside. Sin omega t d of omega t plus pi to 2 pi sin omega t t omega t. This is Im by 2 pi. Okay. Now your output will be like this. 0 to pi it is available. Pi to 2 pi it is 0. There is no waveform. That means this entire part is 0 because there is no output waveform from pi to 2 pi. Therefore, it's cos omega t integration, okay, apply the limits. So, this is, you are going to get it Im by 2 pi into 2, you are going to get it as Im by pi. Therefore, IDC equals to Im by pi for a half-wave rectifier. For a half-wave rectifier, IDC equals to Im by pi. Similarly, average voltage, VDC equals to IDC into RL, V equals to I into RL, I into R. So, VDC equals to IDC into RL. So, it is Im into RL by pi, that can be written as Vm by pi. VDC equals to Vm by pi, IDC equals to Im by pi. The second one is RMS current, root mean square current. Root mean square current. The formula is IRMS equals to square root of like this. So this can be written as Im square by 2 pi sin square omega t sin square omega t. This whole root comes here. Once again this becomes 0. Okay. So what you have to do is Im square by 2 pi 0 to pi 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 into d of omega t. Use this one, integrate it, apply the limit 0 to pi, then you are going to get IRMS equals to Im by 2. Integrate it. Okay, till this one I done, then integrate it, apply the limit 0 to pi, then we are going to get it Im by 2. This is IRMS. Second one is VRMS, next one. Similar to previous one, it is VRMS equals to Vm by 2. Okay. The next one is peak factor. It is Vm by VRMS or Im by IRMS. Peak factor Vm by VRMS or Im by IRMS. Peak factor in terms of voltage or in terms of current. Next one is form factor. Form factor is IRMS by IDC or Vrms by Vdc. Okay. The next one is peak inverse voltage. Peak inverse voltage, I will explain this one. See, if you apply forward bias, this diode is forward bias. If you apply positive half cycle, the diode is forward bias, then you know peak inverse voltage concept right now. Now, if you apply reverse bias, here you will get the negative half cycle. Across the transformer, secondary windings, you will get the negative half cycle. The diode is reverse bias. The diode is reverse bias, current is zero. So, what is the voltage drop across RL? Zero. Now, what is the voltage between these two points? See, KVL, apply KVL. I want voltage across this one. Assume X. X minus 0. Okay? Minus of minus Vm equals to 0. Therefore, X equals to Vm. See, here I have taken X volts. I am applying KVL in this one. X minus this Vm is equals to 0. X equals to Vm. That means under reverse bias condition, voltage across the diode equals to Vm. This is called name peak inverse voltage. It is the maximum voltage, peak voltage that the diode can withstand under inverse condition, means reverse bias. Under reverse bias condition, what is the maximum voltage across the diode? So, under reverse bias condition, the diode is open circuit. There is no voltage drop across this one. So, whatever the voltage available across this one, same voltage will be available across that one. That is X volts. Clear? So, peak inverse voltage equals to Vm. Peak inverse voltage equals to Vm. The next one is ripple factor. Ripple factor, it is denoted by R. It is denoted by R. It is, ripple factor is Vac by Vdc. What is the meaning of Vac by Vdc? This is the output of a half a rectifier. Already I said half a rectifier output contains AC component as well as DC component. AC component is unwanted component. DC component is the required component. So, the output contains unwanted AC component as well as required DC components. This unwanted AC components are called ripples. Unwanted AC component is called ripples. Now, ripple factor, that means how much AC component present with respect to DC. So, output contains AC and DC. The AC component divided by DC component is called ripple factor. Is it clear? How much AC component consider with respect to DC component? If you do the derivation, small derivation will be there. You will get Vrms by Vdc whole square minus 1. This formula is generalized formula. That means it is applicable for half a rectifier, full wave rectifier. Okay, Vrms by Vdc whole square minus 1. For a half-way rectifier, Vrms Vm by 2 divided by Vdc Vm by pi whole square minus 1. So, Vm, Vm will cancel. So, left over is pi by 2 whole square minus 1. If you do, you are going to get it as 1.21. So, ripple factor for a half-wave rectifier is 1.21. Now what is this 1.21 gives to us? What is the meaning of 1.21? VAC equals to 1.21 times VDC. 1.21 into VDC. So assume DC is 1 volt. AC is 1.21 volts. AC component is more or DC component is more? AC component is 1.21 times the DC component. That means the output contains more AC than DC. But what do you require? You require opposite. DC required more, but half a rectifier gives more AC. That's why also half a rectifier is not used practical application, because it's giving more AC. But what do we require? More DC. Clear? Next one. Output frequency and input frequency relation. Output frequency and input frequency relation. Okay. What is meant by frequency? Basic definition, number of cycles per second. Now consider input, this entire thing is 1 second. How many cycles are there? From here to here, 1 cycle. From here to here, another cycle. Therefore, frequency, assume it is 2 hertz. Number of cycles are 2 per second, that is 2. Comes here, this entire thing is 1 second. From here to here, 1 cycle. Cycle means same waveform has to be repeated. From here to here, it is 1 cycle. From here to here, same waveform. See, the waveform starting from same once again here. That's why output also contains 2 cycles. Therefore, output frequency equals to 2 times of the input frequency. The next one is efficiency. Efficiency. This is called conversion efficiency. Conversion efficiency. Why it is called conversion, not simple efficiency? It is converting AC to DC. That's why it is called conversion efficiency. The formula for efficiency equals to output power by input power, that is P naught by PI. Now output is, you require DC. DC power by input is AC power into 100%. P naught DC by PI AC into 100%. Now what is the formula for P naught DC, output DC power? IDC's power formula is V into I, or I square into R, or V square by R. Three formulas are there. We'll use the second formula, I into I square into R. That is, here I square into R means RL. But see here, DC. So it has to be taken as DC. Similarly, PIAC. PI AC. PI AC equals to same I square RMS into RL plus RF. What is RF? Diode forward resistance. See here, you are taking the like this. DC is taken across this one. This is RL. Output DC voltage is taken across this one. Therefore, V naught equals to current flowing through this one into RL. But coming to input AC power, this diode is replaced by some resistance RF. Forward resistance means incremental resistance R, indicated by RF. And the AC voltage in this loop is equals to I square RMS into RF plus RL. This IDC square, IDC for half a rectifier, IDC, Im by pi whole square into RL. Im by 2 whole square into RL plus RF. Okay. Now, substitute this one and this one in this equation, you will get it as 0.406 by 1 plus RF by RL into 100%. This is the formula. RL into 100%. Now, you want maximum efficiency. You want maximum efficiency. When we will get the maximum efficiency? If this denominator, this value is 0. That means RF is 0. When RF is 0, this will get the maximum efficiency and it is 40.6%. Clear? Next. Transformer. Utilization factor. Transformer utilization factor. This is called TUF. That means how effectively you are utilizing the transformer. This is the size of the transformer. Are you effectively you are utilizing the transformer or not? It is called TUF and it is small thing, small change only. It's called PAC rated. This is formula is VRMS rated into IRMS. What is VRMS rated? See here, if you apply positive half cycle, here positive half cycle you are going to get it. If you apply negative half cycle, here you will get the negative half cycle. That means transformer secondary also AC voltage. Primary is AC voltage, transformer secondary voltage is AC. That means both positive half cycle is there, negative half cycle is there. In that case, VRMS is Vm by root 2. Voltage wise, output transformer secondary is a output also, both positive half cycle will be there, negative half cycle will be there. Therefore, for that one, it is Vm by root 2. Next comes during positive half cycle, the diode is forward bias, replaced by short circuit. Current existed or not? Current will be available. During negative half cycle, the diode is reverse bias. Whether current will exist? Whether current will exist under reverse open circuit condition? Current will not be exist. So current will be available only for one half cycle. Therefore, current wise, this is a half rectifier. Transformer secondary voltage available for positive half cycle and negative half cycle. I am right now not considering the RL. I am considering the transformer. For transformer, voltage will be available for the positive and negative half cycle. Whereas current, during positive half cycle it flows. During negative half cycle no current flows. Therefore current wise, it is a, only for one half cycle will be flowing. Therefore it is Im by 2. See this, IRMS is Im by 2. If only for one half cycle current flows, it is Im by root 2. Across the transformer secondary, voltage positive half cycle available, negative half cycle also available. Therefore, it's Vm by. Okay. So, this can be written as V equals to Im into RL by into Im by 2 root 2. Now substitute this one and this one in this one, you are going to get TUF as 0.286. These are called rectifier parameters. IDC, that is average current, average voltage, RMS current, root mean square current, root mean square voltage, peak factor, form factor, peak inverse voltage, ripple factor, output frequency, maximum efficiency, TUF. Clear? Now this is about the half wave rectifier. Now comes to full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier, once again, is classified into two types. Center tapped full wave rectifier. Center tapped full wave rectifier. We'll see this one. Once again, first initially transformer. Here we are using the different transformer, that is, this transformer is called center tapped transformer. Center tapped. One wire is taken from the center of the transformer secondary winding. This is called center tapped transformer. Now, what is the property of center tapped transformer is, if you are giving a positive half cycle, here you will get a positive half cycle, here you will get a negative half cycle. So, amplitude wise, this one and this one is same. This will be larger because it's a step down transformer. Okay, this amplitude and this amplitude is same. And it's here positive half cycle, here negative half cycle comes. That means between this point and this point, there is a 180 degrees phase difference is obtained. Next, if you give negative half cycle as your input signal, then here we'll get the negative half cycle, here we'll get the positive half cycle. That is the property of center tap transformer. Once again, between this point and this point, 180 degrees phase difference is obtained. Now, the main disadvantage with this center tap full wave rectifier is, main disadvantage, in the previous case, normal transformer is required. There is no center tapping is required. But in this case, center tapping is required. What is the disadvantage centered with the center tapped thing? Exactly middle point has to be obtained in the transformer secondary. That means the number of windings here and the number of windings are here has to be exactly equal. Transformer secondary midpoint has to be precisely has to be obtained. It's a little bit difficult. Let us suppose you are not obtained. You are not taken midpoint. What is the problem for us? In that case, output, okay, here let us suppose small amplitude, here we will get the large amplitude. If your number of windings are less, here number of windings are more, then negative half cycle will be more, here positive half cycle will be small. Output also we are going to show, okay, how we are going to get it. So if you are not able to locate the center point exactly, then output will not be exact one. Okay, what is the shape also, I will give it next. Okay. This about the transformer, center tapped transformer. Now comes to the circuit. Diode D1. Diode D2. Resistor RL. This is grounded. 230 volts. 50 hertz. AC signal is given. Output voltage is taken across this one and here it's positive, here it is negative. Now what is going to happen? Working principle. Consider positive half cycle. Consider positive half cycle. The property of center type transformer is here you will get positive half cycle, here you will get negative half cycle. Here positive, this entire cycle is a positive half cycle, means here it's higher potential. Your entire thing is negative half cycle, that means you will have a negative potential. Whereas this cathode, check it, it's grounded. This also grounded. Here 0 volts, here also 0 volts. So, what about this one? Anode is at lower potential than the cathode. Anode is at lower potential. Therefore, this diode is reverse bias. Anode is at higher potential. Here see 0, here higher potential. Therefore, this diode is forward bias. In ideal case, if an ideal diode, it is replaced by open circuit. And it is replaced by forward bias diode, short circuit. And current I1 flows in this direction. That means, if your input is input is a sinusoidal, then what is the output waveform? Because I1 flows, therefore V0 equals to I1 into RL. So during positive half cycle, like this. Draw the waveform carefully. Diode D1 is on. Diode D1 is on. Diode D2 is off, diode D2 is off. Is clear? So there is no current flows through this one. Now your input is negative half cycle. If your input is negative half cycle, you will see this working principle. Diode D1. Here we will have a negative half cycle, here we will have positive half cycle. That means here positive, here 0, here negative. So this diode is reverse bias. This diode is forward bias. Reverse bias diode, replace it by open circuits. So no I1 flows. This one is forward bias, replaced by short circuit. Now I1 flows, I2 flows in this direction. So now output voltage available across RL due to I2. Now I1 is not existed. Therefore output voltage available like this. Here D1 is off, D2 is on. D2 is on. Since negative half cycle are rectified, therefore it is called full wave rectifier. And since we are using a center type of transformer, therefore it is called center type full wave rectifier. Now I said, if the output center point is not taken exactly, what is the problem? What is the expected output waveform? Like this. That means here the number of windings are less, here the number of windings are more, then positive half cycle will be less, negative half cycle will be more. If opposite, here more number of windings means here we are going to get it like this. Okay. If you are able to obtain the center point exactly, then this is the expected waveform. So obtaining the center type transformer is very, very difficult. That is the main one of the disadvantages. Since both are rectifier, therefore it is called full wave rectifier. Okay. Now we have to see the parameters. See here, output is available, previous case output is available from 0 to pi. From pi to pi it is not available. But here 0 to pi is available, pi to 2 pi also it is available. And it is a symmetrical, see 0 to pi like this, pi to 2 pi also it's same thing. Therefore it's a symmetrical waveform. We are going to see that one. Now once again, all the parameters we have to calculate for the Fourier rectifier also, centered or Fourier rectifier also, that we'll see after break. Two pi will cancel. So left over d of omega t will take questions before going further. Fourier rectifier parameters, how to calculate ripple factor. Okay, I think it's not needed, but since you asked, that's I'll explain. See, it contains AC component plus DC component. So at any instant of time, total current equals to AC current plus DC current. AC current plus DC current. Total, at any point of time, total current equals to AC current plus DC current. Therefore, AC current equals to I minus IDC. Therefore, IRMS equals to square root of I minus IDC whole square, 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi d of omega t. This written as 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi I square d of omega t plus 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi I square d omega c minus 2 into 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi I into IDC d omega t. See, this one, 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi, for half a rectifier it's only 0 to pi. So this entire thing is nothing but I square RMS. IDC is a constant. Take it IDC, so integration of 0 to 2 pi, x. Limit, apply the limit 2 pi minus 0, 2 pi, 2 pi, 2 pi will cancel. So, left over is 1. Here, minus 2 into, IDC is a constant, take it outside. So, IDC, left over is 1 by 2 pi integral 0 to pi, I into d of omega t. That's nothing but IDC. This is IRMS. So, what you are going to get it? I square RMS, this is for AC, okay, this is for AC, this is for total. So I square RMS AC is equals to I square RMS minus IDC square. But what is the formula for ripple factor? I square RMS, IRMS AC by IDC or VRMS AC by VDC. So since we calculated this one, what we'll do? I square RMS minus IDC square, and we bring it this one also into inside IDC square. So IRMS by IDC whole square minus 1. Similarly, if you are expressing in terms of voltage, square root of VRMS minus VDC whole square by 1. Since these derivations are not required, that's why I am not going for. For us, the formula is important. That's why, because time is not sufficient, so I am going a little bit faster. These things I am not covering. If you want, I will explain. Next, Mir Faisal, next question. How depletion width of a diode changes with the doping concentration of P region and N region? That's already explained in yesterday's session. Once again, I will explain. This is P-type semiconductor and N-type semiconductor. Okay. Now, here holes are there. Here electrons are there, so and here ions will be there, negative ions, here positive ions will be there, then recombination of the charge carriers, this takes place. Okay, so there is a formation of depletion layer like this. Okay, now the same thing take a p-type semiconductor, n-type semiconductor, heavily doped, 1, 2, 3. Here doping level is increased or not, see, more number, so ions. So here positive ions. So what is going to happen? This recombination takes place, this recombination like this. So if it remove the carriers, the width of the depletion layer is only this much, whereas here the width is this much. So width is changing or not? Okay. Next question. Bharat, why we are calculating RMS current over DC side of the rectifier? Why we are calculating RMS current over DC side of the rectifier? I can't get that question. DC side means, sorry, why we are calculating RMS current over DC side of the rectifier? Sorry, RMS current by DC current. Why we are calculating? That will give you a ripple factor. Sorry, but please once again, I can't understand that question. Please pose once again with little bit clarification. Next question, Deepika Padukon. What is the difference between triode and simple diode? And only formulas of rectifiers are important for whole derivation we need to do. It's exam, gate exam, only formulas are required, not the derivations. If it is a IES exam, then derivations are required. For us, formulas are sufficient. Some cases may be required, because you may not in a position to remember all the formulas, then I am giving the procedure. If you are not able to remember the formula, if you know the procedure, then you can carry out the derivation within a fraction of a second, then you can go use that formula. That's why. Okay? That's why nowhere derivations are required in our case. Okay? But in remembering all the formulas may not be easy. That's why we are going for derivations also, so that you can understand the procedure, then you can do it at that instant of time also if you are unable to remember the formula. Next, what is the difference between triode and simple diode? Diode is having two terminals, triode is having three terminals. Olden days, vacuum tubes, triodes, all those things we are using. Okay? But nowadays, the semiconductors came, diode, transistor. Transistor is a three-terminal semiconductor device. Okay, that's what we are going to use. Okay. Next, what is the difference between RMS and VAC? Okay, AC voltage, see here, we are calculating, let us suppose this VRMS calculated. This is for half a rectifier. For full wave rectifier, VRMS is Vm by root 2, we are going to get it. See here, average here, 0, positive quantity, negative quantity, 0 or not, we are going to get it. Sinusoidal signal, here 0, for positive half cycle equals to negative half cycle, we are going to get it as 0. Okay, but it's a root mean square, you are squaring and you are taking root so that you will get the sum value. Okay, for that purpose we have to take VRMS, root mean square it will give, average value is 0, for that purpose we are going for root mean square. As is AC voltage means, it's 230 volts AC, 230 volts AC means positive cycle equals negative cycle is 0, what you are going to get it? Okay, root mean square we are taking. Meters, ammeters is giving the voltmeters, are there measuring the RMS quantity, not AC quantity. Clear? Next, Kirtana. Sir, is half a rectifier DC current is 0? No. See here, like this you are getting. Okay. DC current means average current. See here, positive half cycle here, negative half cycle here. Here this quantity equals to this quantity. Therefore, output average quantity equals to 0. But any negative quantity is there here in this negative quantity is there? No. Entire thing is positive only. Entire quantity is positive. Therefore, overall average some DC component will be there. Small DC component will be there. If positive quantity, negative quantity with equal magnitude is there, then DC is 0. But in this case, it's not like that. It's there. Some DC component is there. As it, how to calculate triple factor? I think I done the derivation. Next, Shakti Prasad. In transition capacitance formed due to ions and diffusion capacitance due to electrons and holes, please explain the physical meaning of peak factor and form factor. Okay, where these are used. Now, I think whatever you said, initial transition capacitance and diffusion capacitance, what is that is correct. Explain the physical meaning of peak factor and form factor. See here, they are indirectly related to ripple factor. Ripple factor equals to square root of Vrms by Vdc whole square minus 1. Ripple factor must be, it's a AC component by DC component. It should be as low as possible. See, this Vrms by Vdc is nothing but form factor. Form factor whole square minus 1. It's indirectly related to this one. Okay. Peak factor, some of the application, it's relating with respect to maximum. How, whether you require a peak value or not. Okay. Generally, it does not require that much peak thing. Okay. In those cases, peak factor will be given. So we are doing in one problem at the time, you can understand the difference between peak factor and form factor where you are going to use. Next, Shaurav from Kolkata. Why CD greater than CT in forward bias? Sir, IRMS equals to IM by root 2. IRMS equals to IM by, sir, IRMS equals to IM by root 2. For a full wave rectifier, that means if output is like this or if output is like this, IRMS equals to IM by root 2. Clear? Whereas if output is like this, then IRMS equals to IM by 2. So depending on the output waveform shape. The next one, CD greater than CT. See, in forward bias. Already I said, transition capacitance depends on width of the depletion layer. In forward bias condition, the width of the depletion layer is very small. Width of the depletion layer is very small under forward bias condition. Therefore, CT is not going to play any role. Under CD, forward bias condition, diffusion is more. So, CD will be more. So, forward bias condition, diffusion may plays an important role. CD will be existed. Forward bias condition, the width of the depletion layer is very narrow. Okay, transition capacitance depends on the width of the depletion layer. That CT is negligible. Okay, that's clear. Once again, if you want, I pose the once again. I think it is clear. Still, if you are having any doubts, you can explain. Okay, still there are some more questions are there. Around 10 to 15 questions are there. Okay, because of time constraints, today I'm not going to able to in a position to take that one. Tomorrow I'll start with the questions posed by you. Okay, then next session will be continued. Okay, first tomorrow starting I am going to take whatever the questions posed by you today, then we'll start the next class. Is it clear? Thank you.